वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस CIS कैंपस GS यूनिवर्सिटी ज्योग्राफी लेक्चर एंड द टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग टुडे इज़ द लैटिट्यूड एंड द लॉन्गिट्यूड व्हाई द रेलिवेंसी गॉट इमर्ज्ड इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ लैटिट्यूड एंड लॉन्गिट्यूड एंड हाउ द यूटिलाइजेशन इज गोइंग ऑन ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टुडे इन दिस चैप्टर बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर I should explain you that you people don't need to do much about in respect of writing. You have to just understand, analyze this lecture, and the written notes will be provided to all of you in the English format, in the English medium itself, through the description box. In the description box, I have provided you a link where you can go and just copy paste the topics related of latitude and the longitude. The lecture language is completely in this is English, and the lecture of the Hindi medium I have already provided you. So the medium in which you are comfortable, just go on that and take out your lecture and download your notes and just copy paste over there. So we are starting the topic, that is latitudes and longitudes. First, why we need to study the latitude and the longitude? We need to study the latitude and longitude because some imaginary lines have been drawn on the earth. And why they have the earth? So first, both these are imaginary lines. Drawn. And why these have drawn? To locate a given place and determination of time of different place. First, we need to locate any given place on the earth in a specified and the shortest time manner, and then we have to determine the time also. What is the time in India at present? So in respect of Indian time, what is the time of England and what is the time of Tokyo? And what is the time variation in India itself? Though we have adopted the standard meridian of India, and according to that standard meridian 82.5 degree east, we have the all equal time spans over the India technically. But in actually, India has also the variation of about 1 hour 56 minutes from east toward the west. So we need to locate a place. Every given place, remotest place, and time. For the calculation of both these two, some imaginary lines or some not too imaginary lines have been drawn on the earth. Out of those, one is known as latitude and the another one is known as longitudes. So first we can look out the properties of latitude and longitudes. So latitudes are horizontal, latitudes are complete circle, latitudes are 181 in the numbers and divided into north and south. North and south. So first, latitude are the imaginary lines, then drawn horizontally, complete circle, makes a complete circle on the earth, numbers are 181 and divided into the north and south. Now look at the longitudes, vertical, longitudes are vertical, half circle, makes a half circle on the earth. The total numbers are 360 and divided into east and west. Horizontal, vertical, complete circle, half circle, 181, 360, north, south, east and west. And one more important, all longitudes are of same length, whereas the latitudes are not of same length. Now look over here. I have drawn the half diagram, and this half diagram is in respect of latitude. We have discussed what is axis. We have discussed, though it is not axis, don't confuse. We have discussed what is axis. So axis is that imaginary line which pass through the center of the earth, that is from in the middle of the earth, passing through the center of the earth and connecting the north pole and the south pole. That is our northernmost middle sighted point and the southernmost middle point of the earth, known as north point and the south point. So based on the north point and the south point, in the just middle of the north point and the south point of the earth, we draw a horizontal line which known as a equator. We draw a horizontal line which known as a equator. The line which does equate, the line which does equate or divide the earth into two equal halves, that is known as equator. And based on the dividation of the equator, we have northern hemisphere. Hemi means half, northern hemisphere, and then we have the southern hemisphere, and both these are hemispheres are the horizontal hemisphere. We have discussed how many hemispheres and how they have been drawn on the earth. So the hemisphere based on the equator are the horizontal hemisphere, whereas the hemisphere based on the vertical line will be called as a vertical hemisphere. So based on the equator, the earth is divided into that equal half, north hemisphere and south hemisphere. The value of the equator is 0 degree. The value of the equator is 0 and the counting is 1. And starting from the equator toward the north and starting from the equator toward the south, we again draw 90-90 latitude in both hemisphere at the difference of 1 degree each. So at the distance of 1 degree, we draw 90 latitude in the northern hemisphere, and at the distance of 1 degree, we draw the 90 latitude in the southern hemisphere. So 90 in north hemisphere, 90 in southern hemisphere, 1 we have in the middle of the earth, that is equator. So 1 plus 90 plus 90, in total we have 181 latitudes, and latitudes are making a complete circle around the earth. Based on this, that they are making the complete circle around the earth, the length of the equator is 40,075 kilometers, and it is the longest imaginary line drawn on the earth. The longest imaginary line drawn on the earth is equator, with the total length is 40,075 kilometers, and this is known as a equatorial circumference of earth. So we have the equator, which is a latitude. The value of the equator is 0 degree and the length is 40,075 kilometers, and this is also the equatorial circumference of the earth. So the longest imaginary line is in the form of latitude, which is known by the name of equator, with the value of 0 degree. Total length is 40,075 kilometer, and this length also known as the equatorial circumference of the earth. And starting from the equator, at the 1 degree difference, we have the 90 latitude in the northern hemisphere and the 90 latitude in the southern hemisphere. Now imagine I am in Muradabad. This is the city of the UP West, and the distance of Delhi from Muradabad is 165 kilometer, 0 kilometer and 165 kilometer. So Delhi is away from me 165 kilometer by road, right? What should be the aerial difference? So I am assuming the aerial distance, hawa se hawa, the aerial distance between Muradabad and Delhi is 111 kilometer. From where I am getting this figure? So I am getting this figure from here. The distance between the two latitudes anywhere on the earth is 111 kilometer, though technically it is 111.2 kilometer, but we assume in the round figure as 111 kilometer all over the earth. Wherever you are going, wherever you are visiting, wherever you are pointing out, the distance between the two latitude will always be 111 kilometer. That's why if we take the distance, aerial distance is 111 kilometer, still you are finding it difficult to locate any place. So what was the solution? So the solution was traced that the 111 kilometer distance again divided to 60 times, and one divided portion known as minute. So I am zooming out this minute here. So even the distance between these 2 minutes is little less but 2 kilometer. So the aerial difference of 2 kilometer is still a large. So we again divide this minute into the equal 60 times, and the one equal portion is known as second. So latitude, minute and second. So the distance of 111 kilometer is again divided into the equal 60 part, and the one part is known as minute, and again 1 minute is divided into the 60 equal part, which is known as a second. So we can recap over here that on the earth we have two kind of imaginary lines. One is horizontal, which make a complete circle around the earth, and one is latitude, which make a half circle around the earth. It is horizontal latitude, and the latitudes are horizontal while the longitudes are vertical. Longitudes are semicircle and the longitudes are vertical, while the latitudes are horizontal. Difference between the two latitude is 111 kilometer, but moving from the equator towards the pole, from the equator towards the pole, the length of latitude goes on decrease. And the length of 60 degree north latitude or the 60 degree south latitude is just half of the equator, that is 40,075 by
2 किलोमीटर,
हाफ ऑफ द इक्वेटर, 40,075 by 2 किलोमीटर. दिस अगेन प्रूव्ड दैट अर्थ इज इन द जियोइड शेप, नॉट अ कंप्लीट स्फेयर, बट अर्थ इज इन द जियोइड फेस. सो वी हैव द डिफरेंस इन द इक्वेटोरियल सर्कमफेरेंस एंड द पोलर सर्कमफेरेंस. द इक्वेटोरियल सर्कमफेरेंस, दिस इज द इक्वेटर, द इक्वेटोरियल सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ द अर्थ इज 40,075 किलोमीटर, वाइल द पोलर सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ द अर्थ इज 40,008 किलोमीटर. सो द पोलर सर्कमफेरेंस ऑफ द अर्थ इज 40,008 किलोमीटर. सो ऑल टूगेदर वी हैव द डिफरेंस ऑफ 67 किलोमीटर. सो इन द अर्थ द सर्कमफेरेंस डिफरेंस वी हैव ऑफ 67 किलोमीटर. एंड वाई अर्थ इन द जियोइड शेप, जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द ग्रेट मास ऑफ द अर्थ एंड इट्स रोटेशन स्पीड. द रोटेशन स्पीड इज 465 मीटर पर सेकेंड, दैट मीन्स ऑलमोस्ट 500 मीटर पर सेकेंड. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस स्पीड एंड हैविंग द ग्रेट मास, द अर्थ फॉर्म्स अ जियोइड शेप. एंड मूविंग फ्रॉम द इक्वेटर टूवर्ड्स द पोल, द लेंथ ऑफ द लैटिट्यूड गोज ऑन डिक्रीज. सो इन स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द लेट इन डिस्कसिंग ऑफ द लैटिट्यूड, वी हैव द हॉरिजॉन्टल लाइन मेकिंग द कंप्लीट सर्किल ऑन द अर्थ. वी हैव द ऑल टूगेदर 181 लैटिट्यूड्स. एंड मूविंग फ्रॉम द इक्वेटर टूवर्ड द पोल, द लेंथ ऑफ द लैटिट्यूड गोज ऑन डिक्रीज, विच बिकम्स 0 किलोमीटर एट पोल. 0 किलोमीटर, विच बिकम्स 0 किलोमीटर एट पोल. द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू लैटिट्यूड 111 किलोमीटर डिवाइडेड इन टू द मिनट्स एंड द सेकेंड विद द 60-60 इक्वल पार्ट्स ईच. एंड देन नाउ वी मूविंग टू द लॉन्गिट्यूड्स. द वर्टिकल सेमी सर्किल लाइन ड्रॉन ऑन द अर्थ, द वर्टिकल सेमी सर्किल लाइन ड्रॉन ऑन द अर्थ कनेक्टिंग द नॉर्थ पोल एंड द साउथ पोल, कनेक्टिंग द नॉर्थ पोल एंड साउथ पोल आर नोन एज longitudes, are known as longitude. Because these are the semicircle and the vertical, the total number of the longitude is 360 longitudes. Now, I have told you earlier that the eastern and the western hemisphere divided based on the longitudes. So based on the longitude, we have two hemisphere. Eastern hemisphere and Western hemisphere. In the eastern hemisphere, we have 180 longitudes. And also in the western hemisphere, we have 180 longitudes. Now the base longitude is this one, prime meridian, 0 degree. Because based on this, the earth is divided into the two hemisphere, eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. So we have 180 plus 1 plus 180. In total, it should be 361, but actually in counting, these are 360. So what is this twist? Just backside of the 0 degree longitudes, we have 180 degree longitude. If we connect 0 degree longitude and 180 degree longitude, then the total length we have already discussed is 40,008 kilometer. And we also know that these are the semicircle. So just in the back of the 0 degree longitude, we have the 180 degree longitude. And 180 degree longitude is same for both the hemisphere. 180 degree longitude is same for the both the hemisphere. So if you are counting from the eastern hemisphere, you will call it 180 degree eastern longitude, and if you are counting from the western hemisphere, you will call it 180 degree western longitude. So the 180 degree is common for both the hemisphere. That's why you have to minus from any of the hemisphere the number 1. So we can write it as a 179 plus 180 or 180 plus 179. So whatever you wish, but the total counting is a 360, right? So in counting we have the 360 longitude, in counting we have the 181 latitude. Now the difference, the distance between the two latitude is always same all over the earth. आप कहीं भी चले हैं, the distance will be the same. But first I must draw the longitude. Then we will forward our lecture. So these are the longitudes I have drawn here over here. Right, and here we have 90 degree west, and here we have 90 degree east. Based on this, this is eastern hemisphere. And based on this, this is western hemisphere. You people just have to look over here and understand the lecture. The written notes are provided to you in its complete format. Take. So based on the longitude, we have the eastern hemisphere and the western hemisphere. In the middle of the eastern hemisphere with the 90 degree west, and then to the backward side 180 degree west. In the middle of the eastern hemisphere we have the 90 degree east, and then to the backward side 180 degree east. Now at the equator the distance between the two latitude also is 111 kilometer at the equator only. And when we move from the equator towards the pole, the distance goes on decreasing and it merged to 0 kilometer at equator. So from which line you are coming at the pole, either from following the latitude or from following the latitude, you will be at the 0 kilometer finding distance at any other pole, right? So the difference between the latitude and the longitude is, when we move from the equator towards the pole, the distance between the two latitude is same, but the length goes on decrease. And in respect of the longitude, the distance between the two longitude moving from the equator towards the pole goes on decreasing, but the length will be the same. So in these two respect, both the lines act opposite to each other, right? Now, importance in finding out the place. Sorry, one more point. And again, the distance between the two longitude is divided into the 60 equal part, and each part is known as minute. Now I'm zooming out here. And again, the minute is divided into the 60 equal part, which is known as second. And then Indian government issued the order secretly that we have to do air strike in Balakot of Pakistan, and Jaguar planes are ready to strike. But where to strike, pilot don't know what is the terrain and from where the international boundary or the LOC is getting started or what is the demarcation. So taking the cognizance of these two imaginary lines, a calculate is feed out in the Jaguar plane, and the Jaguar plane calculation says that when we reached on 20 degree north, that is 20 degree 35 minutes and 40 second north latitude, and on reaching on this latitude, when we are encountered with longitude, the calculation is 30 degree 15 minutes 22 second east. The intersecting point, on this intersecting point we have to start bombardment. Spike missile we have to draw over here, and that's how the launching pad of terrorist will be destroyed. And given the specification of this calculation, the ordinary masses of Pakistan will be safe. Only the terrorist launching pad will be destroyed. So this is the utility in the navigation also, where in the airplane also, and whatever you are doing. So finding out the any place with the calculation, with the measured calculation of these two lines, you can find out any remotest to remotest place on the earth. Another utility is the determination of time, which we will discuss and calculate some of the questions in the next lecture. Thank you for now. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.